And here we are again. Hello, hello. Back with another Let's Play walkthrough type thing, of course. Much more a Let's Play, I think. You can't really walk through Ticket to Ride to any great extent, I suppose. But today, we shall be going through a quick, well, quote-unquote, hopefully a quick game of Ticket to Ride Europe. The second, I believe, to come out. Because it was America, then it was Europe. Or was it Switzerland? Switzerland might have came out, and then Europe, and then Switzerland went out of stock, and then it was reprinted, and I don't know. There's so many variations out at this point, you can't even count them on one hand. And as of recording this, I've just realised, or I've just been notified, that a new map collection is coming out, Ticket to Ride Nederland, you know, obviously for the Netherlands. Looks really cool. There's now a mechanic where, like, pretty much all of these, like, routes that are in it are like doubles, you know, so like these ones here. But the awesome thing is that if the first person to claim it now has to pay a cost of like bridge toll tokens, and that goes straight to the bank. But whenever someone wants to claim the second route, they have to pay the player that got the first one. That sounds like so awesome. I know I'm like going to sound really sad by saying that, but that just sounds really cool. Like a lot more player interaction than you would ordinarily have, a bit more forward planning, I suppose, than you would necessarily have. But yeah, that sounds really cool. So it's going to be releasing at Essen this October in Germany, apparently, and it'll be in game stores roughly at the same time as what Days of Wonder are saying in the US in November. So definitely picking that up before Christmas probably. But anyway. Enough sidetracking, let's get on to the actual game itself. Solo, obviously, online, because I don't really want to be harassed by other people. And I'm probably going to pick 4 players for this. I could pick 5, but it might just make it last a wee bit too long, be a wee bit too contentious. I think 4 is a good number. 3 is pretty good as well, but it might just be a wee bit too sparse. I think 4 is the magic number, so we'll go for this. And this is me, this guy here, playing as blue. Okie doke, so what cards do we have? So, Palermo to Moskva. Okay. So, I mean, typically the way I tend to play Ticket to Ride is I usually tend to get the long route and then any short routes that happen to fall within it, because you're just being more efficient at that point. You know, you're getting your long route there, plus if you're able to connect those routes that make up the shorter ones in, you know, the meantime, you're essentially spending less trains, but you're still getting more points out of it. That's typically the way I tend to play it, but that is not the case this time, because everything is pretty much all over the place. Thankfully, unlike real life, you've not got players hassling you going, come on, pick your tickets already. God, what am I going to do? These two are pretty close to each other, because I could make a route. It does involve a lot of tunnels, though, but I could make this route here that connects up and then back round, although it's really in this like centre area and it's going to be quite contested. Unfortunately, I have to pick at least 2, so I think I'll go with my long route and... God, it's really 6.5 dozen. I will have to go through Bucharest anyway. I wonder. Might be able to get these ones up here and just latch that on to Moskva, and then. Because I'll probably be building around here, here. Might go that way. I'll definitely have to get these first. Yeah. Okie doke. So that seems... Unless I just pick one that's like super duper simple to do and just completely ignore it, but nah. We'll pick this and get this game started. Okie doke. So... What am I going to need first? Well, I've already got 1 wild in the bank. And she's already taken that. That's great. Just as well I didn't pick that route. So I've already got a wild in the bank, so I just need another one there. None up so far. Oh, I know what I could do. I could make this a wee bit simpler. If I go two reds there, that helps me get there. And if I build to Moskva to this way and then latch off that way, that'd be good. We'll pick up a yellow because we need that one as well. Up another red, nothing there. I'll get another red. Oh, son of a bitch! God damn it! Right, okay, well that's that out the window then. I guess I'm gonna have to use a train station for that one. Was really hoping to avoid using them. I mean, it's only worth 4 points, you know, so it's not really, you know, it's not worth. I suppose rage quitting over, it's not the end of the world, but it's just, it's super annoying. But again, it's to be expected if you're playing with like four players at this point. I need an orange to start this route off. I need to start laying some track down because it's going to get pretty busy pretty quickly. Having played the game quite a lot, I know that there's a route from what is it again? I think it's either is it Stockholm to Constantinople, or is it Petrograd to Constantinople? No, I know there's one from Edinburgh to Athena because I've gotten that like so many times when I've been playing that goes like pretty much through there. But there is one from Stockholm. Oh wait, no, it's Stockholm to Cadiz. That's what it is. That goes that way there. But there's definitely one from Petrograd, I just can't remember what it is for the life of me. Ooh, I'm getting orange. Even though I know there's a very likely chance he's probably going to place that soon and block me off like a bitch. But hopefully that doesn't happen. So, orange and what else should I get? Because see now I'm gonna have to like modify the route where I'm gonna have to go that way. I can either place a train station and then cut through there, or I can just keep going with this massive train and hook back on itself, and then continue along the main path that I was going before. But that involves going through like a four, like it does involve going through a train station. It's only three cards though, I suppose. So we'll see if I can still make this. I might go for it, but we'll see how it goes. Take one from the top. Hey! That's what I like to see. So now. I think I'm gonna get. Right, let's claim this one before that goes anywhere. I think what we'll do. Oh my god. I'm just getting decimated here. That's unfortunate. Right, I was going to wait another turn and get whites and start laying that down there, but that's not going to happen now. And it's doubly frustrating because your train stations, once you place them within a city, you can only use one other person's route to claim it, so. So either I place two train stations, one here, and then that gets me both of these routes, or I build round this, you know, I need another five. Thankfully only two of them are, or you know, one of them's a two grey route, so that's not too bad, but that three red one, that could be pretty annoying. Right, what are we gonna do? Decisions, decisions. Got a random, got a yellow, that's good. That allows me to fill that in. And got an orange. So hopefully as long as, yep, he's taking cards. As long as they don't fill this route in. Good, good, good. Right, I'll claim this now before things get worse. Where is he building? So now, again, another decision. I can either take the three yellow, which shortcuts into, you know, Simra, however you pronounce that, into Palermo. Three would save quite a bit, although I have spent four already, so they'll be at the bottom of the deck. Apparently it's half full, but there's a good chance I'm not going to see those again for a while, because if I remember right, there's like 12 of each card. This is a great game if you want to, like, card count, you know, if you're approaching Rain Man levels of card counting. I mean, this is the game for you, because you can just, you know, have a field day with, like, where all the different types of cards that have been played are and where all that stuff is. But oh god, what's the choice. I think what I'm going to do instead is I'll take this grey route here, and then that can build into Athena. I would have been better doing something else. No, I definitely need that. Actually, I was going to say I had those, because I definitely need those two wilds for those there. Pick up the oranges and hope another one comes out. Well, that blocks off that route then. Okay, so I'm gonna have to claim this one. Go so red. Right, okay. Cause obviously if I didn't claim that one, then it makes it so much harder trying to find like a route to get round there. I could have claimed that, I suppose, and then hoped, like, or I could use my three oranges there. That might have been the smarter play. That's a backup. If I can't, well, obviously if I can't make this, then I'm screwed, but so yeah, I'll take a wild, take that, a wild, we'll take an orange. So now I just need a wild to appear. Where are we sitting trains wise? I'm pretty much even. I'm like, what's that, second place? He's on 33 at the moment. He's on 37. No one's used a train station yet, but that usually comes towards the end of the game when you need to make your routes. No luck on that. Ooh, he's taking that. I honestly have no idea what the hell this is. Like, I don't know what route he's building in, because I can understand going to Petrograd, because I'm pretty sure there's a long route up there, but yeah, I have no idea what this thing here is. She is almost certainly going Edinburgh to Athena. Hey, there we go. It's a wild. Cool, so as long as yellow doesn't... Oh, you are got to be joking. You have got to be kidding me. What the hell? what a joke. What a joke. Ah, dear. Right, okay. That'll be that then. Again, right, let's see, collateral, what's the best way to get out of this situation? Well, I can use three oranges there, and then I'm just going to have to build back round again. Yeah, that was definitely a waste. I should have went there. Right, I'll do three because I have to. Because now I'm gonna have to drop a third train station there. No orange cards. So that's successful. Quite an inefficient way that she's doing this, but she must have not gotten any wilds for this, because she's going to have to obviously hook back round into here, which makes this one a wee bit weird. Because again, this area here, like within your France, Germany, and like little bit of Spain at the bottom, like this area here is like usually very contested, because you've got long routes that are going like this direction and then across the maps and like each every way, plus you've got quite a lot of short routes within here, so this is usually the most contested area. It's weird that there's like so much stuff on the borders, so to speak, but it is what it is, unfortunately, with the luck of the draw. Okay, so essentials are the three yellows, because I can't make the connection, or I can't make it efficiently otherwise without it. So I could burn two wilds when I eventually get a yellow to do it, but I'll try and secure this one first. And I obviously have a terrible memory, I can't remember what's been played too much at this point, so just pick... I don't think I've seen a lot of greens. I'm just trying to look at all the root colours. There's like four up there. Actually, now that I think about it, you'd want the opposite, wouldn't you? Because then that would indicate they're all on the bottom. Screw it. I'll go with white. Yay! Oh, just as well, I didn't pick a green. Awesome. Okay, so... Wow, what's she doing? That's... That's really weird. I thought she would have been going Edinburgh to Athena, but she seems to be... Like, she's been... I mean, fair enough, she's been blocked here, and then she's kind of just went, fuck it, I'm just going to give up, which, you know, that's fair enough, but, you know, a train station easily connects you there. So I don't know what she's thinking, but if it ends up hurting her score at the end, I'm not going to complain. So if we take a tally, I need a train station here, train station there, and I need a train station there. So that's pretty much all three of my train stations gone, so I'm 12 points down on what I could potentially be. So hopefully I don't get blocked anymore. I'm sitting at 29 trains, 26, 26, 29. If I'm lucky, hopefully I should be able to get at least one more route out of this, one more, you know, destination ticket, hopefully. But we'll see. But anyway, hey, there's a wild, and that's a pink. So that's not too bad. Okay, so... No one blocked me this turn for a change. So if I waste three wilds on this, then that secures both of my destination tickets once I get... obviously the cards to lay them down. I've got a single orange for the first one. I've got plenty of doubles for the... Oh, he's already completed his tickets. Ah, so he must have had pretty short ones, so he might have had that and like Vine to Bucharesti. That could possibly explain it. But there's gotta be a more efficient way, surely he would just do that. Or maybe it's smart enough to go from Vine or how you pronounce it. Wine? No, it's not Wine. Vine, like V I Geography or pronunciations of all Yoldy Europe isn't really my strong point, sadly, but maybe he just did that and he wanted to be a dick and just block it that way because he detected, I hate to use it, you know, treat it as if it's computer, but it is actually AI, so it's fine, but he must have detected that I was like building, you know, stuff down here and stuff up here, and he thought, aha, I know that's a route, so I'm going to block you like an arsehole. But anyway, first train station. I do want to build a train station. Boom. So that's the first one. Takes a turn, which is unfortunate, but it will allow me to get the routes that I desire. I mean, it's a bit unfortunate because it's turned what would be 28 points worth of tickets at the end. I've now, you know, shrunk that down by 12. So that's almost 50% of the points gone just from like sheer blocking of stuff. So, it's quite annoying. And as long as someone doesn't steal the greens... she's taking more tickets as well. Wow, she picked up some really short ones. Interesting. Right, so we'll pick that up and pick that. Won't get wild, unfortunately. So, I mean, thoughts overall on Ticket to Ride as a board game series... Ooh, that's a wild. Ooh, but I don't need it, unfortunately, not yet. I mean, there's pretty much no version of Ticket to Ride that I won't play. I mean, to be honest, there's no version that's, like, boring. At least for me. You know, I will happily play any version that people want to play, so to speak. I'll just get new tickets here. Hopefully it's something decent. And... Oh. Now, no doubt if I pick this one, I'm going to get blocked by here for some stupid reason. But this one doesn't help me at all because I would have to go through there. Actually, it's completely blocked, so I'd have to take that long route, and that's just not worth it. That's pretty much half blocked as well, so that's no use. So we definitely want Athena because I can use this existing route with the train station. I just need to make sure that I get those two there, which I think I've got the cards for. I do indeed, two reds, but even if the worst comes to the worst, I can go round there, and if that gets taken, then I've got to go round the long way, in which case it'll be very, very sad, but hopefully that doesn't get taken. I think green would be the only person that would want to take it anyway. Yep, she's still messing about here for some stupid reason. And she's taking more tickets. Excellent, so that is... two tickets to get 11 points. That's very, very good. But yeah, anyway, I mean, back to the different versions. Like, I first got into Ticket to Ride Europe. Saw it being played online somewhere, just like, it didn't show off like most of it, but they showed off enough to where I was like, that seems like really, you know, it was really the first game, or like, it seemed really interesting. It was like one of the very first games that actually got me into like this new generation of board games, I suppose, if you wanted to call it that. Oh, I can do that as well. Fantastic, take that one. That one I'm not going to risk because I'm going to have to go or Budapest to Sofia because he's went and taken that one, but even though it's only like another two there or a three blue, it's a lot of tunnels to go through and that's just not really worth the risk, I think. This one though, I don't know if it's, well, it's worth 13 points. I'm pretty far behind. This one here would effectively cancel out the points that I've lost from, you know, this whole train station fiasco. So I think, I mean, what are they sitting at? Four tickets, two tickets, four tickets. I have, I think I've completed three at this point. There's one, two, yeah, I've completed three, so... I think I'm going to have to go for it, unfortunately. I'm either going to win big or lose big. Five plus the... yeah. I'm getting myself confused there. So, reds and blacks is what do we need. Cool. So yeah, I mean, Ticket to Ride Europe was pretty much the first game that got me into, like, Euro games as a whole. And pretty much... every version of Ticket to Ride that's came out since then I've bought. I was a wee bit hesitant on Heart of Africa for some reason. Oh, that's a good one. Oh, fantastic. I was like a wee bit hesitant on it because like I just wasn't sure if the whole like new mechanic of like the terrain cards, I didn't know if that would like really add enough to it. But having played quite a few games, it does add quite a bit to it. It allows you to really double down on certain routes because it does mean that you can like complete some shorter routes that you pick up at the start and then focus on nothing but terrain cards and laying down like six train routes, you know, and scoring 30 points instead of 15 can be quite devastating if you are able to do it long enough. There aren't that many long routes within Africa, to be able to do it though. But still, I mean, if you're claiming like four routes all the time, you're getting 14 points after 14 points, like it does add up after a while. But it's really fun. Again, like I said, there's not one version of Ticket to Ride that I won't play. I have heard, however, that Ticket to Ride Switzerland, I think, is a little bit broken in terms of like the cards that are put within it because they have a higher proportionality of stuff that's on the left-hand side of the map versus the right-hand side of the map. So if you the common strategy seems to be that if you just build a lot of routes on the left-hand side and then keep taking tickets, you're going to have so many that like overlap with each other because you've built so many routes on the left-hand side. You'll just win automatically because of that. So that seems a little less fun, but again, I haven't really played with any you know, set of people that you know, tend to find that a problem. And I don't really try and game the system that way anyway. I kind of just see you know, what tickets come up and roll with it, so to speak. So anyway, 15 trains. Is it worth taking the risk? We'll go for it. See what happens because I really need to catch up. Fantastic. So that's Berlin to Moscow. That's another 12 points for free. I mean, this is really where it starts to become like awesome if you can just like build. I mean, there's quite a lot of luck involved in it, but if you can build certain routes to where you get new destination tickets and they already perfectly slot in, then you know you can easily win games that way. So that's me just picked up 12 points for literally nothing. Not sure what to do. I think I might just go and spend like these last few turns here just trying to block the AI wherever possible, kind of make up for the horrific start that I had. Well, it wasn't horrific, it was unlucky. There is a difference, I suppose. I can't. Have I picked one already? That's strange because usually you can pick. Unless I've already picked one. Oh, yeah. I was going to say, like you should be able to pick up the face-up card, but I've already picked one up already, so. So who's got the most points? Red has the most points at the moment. Pick up this wild now. There isn't really too many places to block. When it comes to this stuff, because I have given up on trying to figure out what this is because, like, I thought it was Edinburgh to Athena. It could very well have been, and then she's just been blocked and she's given up. But it also looks like she's going Stockholm to Cadiz, but then she seems to have given up on that as well. And now she's like building all these like short routes in the middle. Kind of doesn't make any sense, but I'll just start putting trains down, try and burn through them all before she's able to run out of them. And then hopefully that's enough. Oh, that'd be a good one. That's going to screw someone over. Has to. There's too many trains overlapping, it can't not screw someone up. I think I should probably give up my hopes of like trying to find or like trying to obtain the longest route for this game, because I don't think I have it at all. What have we got? 2, 5. Yeah, that's terrible. I think Red's got it. She's got this like massive train that's all the way around there, so I think she easily has that, so I can't really contest her for it, so there's not much point trying. The best I can do is just put down random trains somewhere and hope that it messes someone up. Go blue and we'll take a random, that's unfortunate. Although, could put that there. I forget the official rules. It's been a while since I've played the actual Europe variation, but I forget if the train stations that you use count as part of the longest continuous route. Something sticks in my mind that it doesn't. Like, I think I did look up the rules now at one point, and it's like it had to be a continuous route of your own trains, because that kind of makes sense if you think about it. Because if you could use other people's trains and they had like this massive 8 route along here, that's giving you 8 free trains just for one train, like for one card, or you know, up to 3 cards played essentially, so that wouldn't be particularly fair. So some sticks in mind you can't use these ones here, so I'm probably still not going to get it. Unless I was able to, what have I got, 14, 3, yeah, 8 and 3 is 11, so maybe if I was able to get these last 3 up here, I could do it, but I just don't have the cards to do it. I've ran out of time, unfortunately. If only I had another pink, I could maybe block that off. Go for the yellows instead. Mm-hmm. 6 trains left, so I'm at 14, so I'm not as far behind as yellow, but I still need to start really burning through these now by whatever means necessary. That was a good one. God, 75 points. That's a wee bit worrying. He's only got one train left. Damn it. I like that. Brackets risky, as if, yeah. As if it's saying, don't do it, you fool. Right, so, unfortunately, the best that I can do is 2. So, unless she plays a 5 route. Nope. Oh, here we go. So, 9, an 8, a 6, an 8, and a 6, yeah. So he just went with a bunch of short routes. Plus he seems to have the longest continuous route. Oh, I don't think I'm going to win this one. Oh wait, no, that was the trains, wasn't it? She was blocked from that one. Yeah, so I've got 20, so that helps, but I don't know. It's gonna be close. Ah, just caught out in no more. Did get second place though, that's pretty good. What was that, 9 points difference? So if I wasn't blocked with all those 3 train stations, I would have won, just, but unfortunately it was not to be. But still, second place within a very contested map is not too bad at all. Certainly better than yellow. I think she just got blocked right at the start and just gave up. But yeah, that was not too bad. I don't think there was any major mistakes that I made. Could have, instead of putting those 2 trains right at the south of the map, I probably should have tried to link that back into the main route again, to build off of what, you know, the long continuous main route that I had from Palermo to Moskva. But yeah, apart from that, I really couldn't do much else. Just played the trains as I had them. Still glad that I took the extra train cards because it got, or you know, the destination tickets because it got me an extra like 23 odd points just for existing routes that I already had built down, or you know, I'd already built on the track. So yeah, don't think I really could have done much else. So yeah, nice, quick, easy game. And with that, we'll see you next time. See you then.